Now let's move towards the next topic, that is arrow function. This is our previous example. Let's rerun and see the result. The result is 4. Now let's convert the same function into an arrow function. In order to create the arrow function, you need to remove this function keyword from the function and apply an arrow pointer after the brackets. After the brackets, you need to provide the arrow pointer. This becomes the arrow function and it still results the same and it returns the 4. Then what is the use of this function when it behaves the same? Whenever you have certain functions which has very limited set of operations to be performed within the function, at that time you can reduce the number of lines and resize that function by using the arrow pointer. These arrow functions can even be smaller if you have specific return value within a function. So I can write down the same function now like this and it will still work the same. Let's rerun the application and you can see that the output is still same. So advantage is, whenever you are creating an arrow function, you can write the constant arrow function name equals bracket with some parameters, then arrow pointer, and then the return value without return keyword. So you have replaced two things. Function keyword is not there, return keyword is not there, and the curly braces are not there. So it becomes very lightweight in terms of coding is concerned. But apart from that, it has certain limitations. This keyword within the boundary of the arrow pointer or arrow function is not available. Means the value of objects, this pointer cannot be accessed using this pointer. So how to deal with it? Whenever you are using a class along with the function with arrow pointer, how to deal with it? We'll see it in our upcoming session. Stay tuned.